Hey everybody, I'm Jess Altieri. And I'm here to share with you the best wine, food, and lifestyle pairings around so you can indulge without the extra calories.
Hey there, I'm Jess Altieri, and welcome to Killer Pairings with Wine Channel TV as we are gearing up for Sauv Blanc Day on May 16th with St. Supery Vineyards and Winery. Today, I'm at the legendary Shaw's Crab House in Chicago, joined by Jim. Great to see you.
Great to see you. Thank you.
And we are in the famous Oyster Bar, and today we're going to be talking about the perfect killer pairings to go with three fantastic wines from St. Supery. And before we get into that a little bit, can you tell us about Shaw's? As I mentioned, I know it's legendary here in Chicago.
It is. Shaw's has been here now for about 30 years. We'll be 30 years old in December. We've kind of the mainstay, the go-to restaurant for seafood in Chicago.
It is. It's always been my perfect killer pairing, especially with Sauv Blanc. And so today we're talking about three fantastic dishes that you have here. And let's talk about the wine though first,
sure.
Obviously. So first we have the St. Supery. This is the 2013 Napa Valley Estate Sauvignon Blanc. And that's what we're sipping. Tell me what you get, but I get almost fresh, I would say, like lemon zest, a little bit of grapefruit and lime, and even lime, I would say flavors and aromas.
Definitely, I get a lot of lemon zest, some grapefruit, maybe even a little bit of peach on the nose.
Ooh, I like that, I think you're right. So, but it has that like crisp, zingy citrus finish that I think would be a perfect pairing with the oysters.
Really good acidity that go well with the oysters.
And that's what you're known for here. Tell me about that. I know you guys sold over 650,000 oysters
just last year. We sold over 650,000 oysters just at Shaw's Crab House. We serve a dozen different oysters every day.
Okay.
Just East and West Coast oysters only.
Got it.
And we buy them when they're at their best.
Wow. Hey, you got me sold. I say that's the perfect killer pairing. So then we have the 2012, this is the Dollar Hyde Estate Vineyard Sauvignon Blanc. And tell me what you get with this one. I think it also has almost, you get the fresh grapefruit notes on there, the lemon zest, a little bit of lovely, I would say, lychee kind of notes
lychee
in there.
Fruit, definitely.
But it has the wonderful hint of almost smoky oak on the nose.
It does, and the oak really comes through on the wine, especially compared to the estate wine where it's really crisp and acidic. This wine has just a nice smokiness to it that I think would go really nicely with the food.
I agree, because when you take a sip, you'll see it has that bright grapefruit and lemon zest kind of rind note to it, but then you get that oak punch. And so I know this dish, you can describe it a little bit more, but it has the Meyer lemon dressing.
Absolutely.
There, right?
So this dish is a mustard char glazed swordfish.
Nice.
And that's served with a little bit of the shaved Brussels sprouts, almonds, manchego cheese, a Meyer lemon vinaigrette, which really would get picked up nicely with the wine.
Right.
And then it has a little bit of stone ground mustard sauce as well. So I think the smokiness of the wine picks up the almonds and the manchego really well as the citrus component of the wine picks up on the Meyer lemon vinaigrette,
Yeah, oh, that's a perfect killer pairing in my book. And then we gotta talk about the last wine. So this is the fantastic 2012 Napa Valley Vertu. So this is Semillon Sauvignon Blanc blend. And I would say this almost has delicious sort of kiwi, fig, a little bit of the lemon zest, the grapefruit notes as well in the nose. But then you get the French toasty oak notes in there as well.
Yes, yes. And the wine has extended lees contact,
exactly.
So it has a richness to it, plus the Semillon being a little bit more full and rich than the Sauvignon Blanc that's in it. The richness of the wine compares nicely with the fat in the food that we have paired.
I agree, because you get that, the bright, again, lemongrass and sort of, lemon zest notes, but then that creaminess from the Surly maturation. Mm-hmm. So you get that, I think it'd be a perfect complement with the creamy lobster and the mayo in there and really bring out the flavors.
I think so.
I like that. Huh. Fantastic. So I think we have our perfect killer pairings for Sauv Blanc Day. Again, everyone, make sure to visit winechanneltv.com for more information. It'll be on May 16th. And hopefully they can join us here at Shaw's.
They
if
can.
Not, join us virtually. Until next time, I'm just Jess, reminding you that wine is just a conversation waiting to happen. Cheers.
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 Thank you.
Thank you.